Good morning, class. Today we are going to start our third chapter, that is the Earth's major water bodies. Here we will discuss about the water bodies like ocean, seas, rivers, lakes in this chapter. Okay, so here first of all, we know that oceans and seas can have salt water, and rivers have fresh water, and the lakes may have fresh water or the salt water. We will discuss them one by one in a detailed way. Okay, so first of all, I'll tell you one thing, that see, if this is a globe, or you can say the earth, so we are dividing it into two parts, or you can say into two equal parts. So this line we can say is known as equator, okay, and this is known as north pole, or we can say northern hemisphere. This is known as southern hemisphere. Okay, this is known as northern hemisphere, and this one is known as southern hemisphere. And in the figure as given downside, here can see the portion which is this one. Okay, so this is covering most of the land, means here we can see that land is more, land masses is more in the northern hemisphere. That's why this is known as land hemisphere. Then down portion, the southern portion, you can see that here most of the area is covered by ocean and seas. That's why it is known as water hemisphere. The two difference is given here, land hemisphere and water hemisphere, and this line is given known as equator. It is dividing the globe into two parts, okay, known as hemisphere. Next is oceans. So how you can learn the oceans? There is one formula, or you can say you can learn in this form, PAISA, PAISA. Okay, PAISA, you can say it is a short form to learn the oceans. First of all, what the ocean is. Ocean, you can say that the area which is covering the water. Okay, so here we can see the vast area of the water surrounding the land masses on the earth are called oceans. The area, you can see here, it is given like, if they are surrounding it with water, then this area is known as oceans. Okay, like this area, this is known as ocean. Next is, there are five different types of oceans. First one is Pacific Ocean. Then second is Atlantic Ocean. Third is Indian Ocean. Next is Southern Ocean, which is also known as Antarctic Ocean. Then the last one is Arctic Ocean. You have to learn these names by the formula PAISA. Okay, I hope you understood this thing. Next is, we will discuss them in detailed way. What is Pacific Ocean, then Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Arctic Ocean and Southern Ocean. Okay, so first one is given here, Pacific Ocean. It means we can say that this is the largest ocean of the world. We have read in the previous classes also, you have read from the third class, fourth class and fifth class, you have discussed in that also, that Pacific Ocean is the largest ocean of the world. It covers almost one third of the globe. You can underline this thing, it covers almost one third of the globe. Next is that the greatest depth of the earth's surface, which is in the Mariana Trench, and this also lies in the Pacific Ocean, because this is the largest ocean, and that's why the Mariana Trench is also found here. Next is that the shape of the ocean is nearly circular. You can underline this thing also, that the shape of the Pacific Ocean is nearly circular. On one side lies the Americas and the other Asia and Australia. It is given in the figure also, 3.1, you can check from there. And in the north, it is linked to the Arctic Ocean. And in the south, the Pacific Ocean is largely open. So you can just see all these things from the figure 3.1. Okay, next thing is that the Atlantic Ocean. This is the second largest ocean of the world. You have to underline this thing. It is the second largest ocean of the world, but its area is half of the Pacific Ocean. You are getting the thing that Pacific Ocean is that much big ki Atlantic Ocean is just having a half of the area compared to the Pacific Ocean. Okay, next is that the shape of this ocean resembles the letter S. Okay, it is in the shape of S. Next is that to the north it merges into the Arctic Ocean, and to the south it extends up to the Antarctica. It is bound on the west by North America and South America, and on the east by Europe and Africa. Each and everything is given here in the figure 3.1. You can just check it. And one more thing, that Atlantic Ocean is the busiest ocean from the point of view of trade. Means you can exchange the goods and services from this area. Trade means exchange of goods and services. So the people are having the best location, means they can just transport their goods from the Atlantic Ocean. And that's why it is the busiest ocean, because the harbor, it is the best ideal location for ports and harbors. Okay, so that's why this is the busiest ocean. Next is Indian Ocean. First of all, you have to underline this thing. This ocean covers almost 1/5 of the total area under oceans and seas. Okay, next thing is that its shape is in triangular. Okay, like this. Next, it is bounded by the continents of Asia. Asia is located at the head of this ocean. India is located at the head of this ocean. It is given in the figure also. You can just check it from there. Then Africa and Australia are to the west and the east of this ocean. The location is given here. You can just find out there from the figure 3.1. Next is the last one, that is Arctic Ocean. Not the last one, this is the fourth one. Arctic Ocean. Arctic Ocean is just, you can say, it lies to the north of the continent of North America, Europe and Asia. And it surrounds the North Pole. As we know, and we have discussed previously also, that North Pole and the South Pole, these are the poles which is having a very high temperature, very low temperature. Because of that, it remains cold. We cannot live there. Okay, so that's why, because of the closeness of to the North Pole, much of the remains covered with ice throughout the year. Means most of the area is covered with ice. Next is, apart from these four oceans, there is the Southern Ocean, or we can say the Antarctic Ocean. This surrounds the continent of Antarctica. You can see this is to the down portion, means where we have discussed now. I'll tell you that also. The down portion, this one, southern portion. Okay, southern hemisphere. So this one is known as, here it is known as Antarctic Ocean. So this one also is having a low temperature, because this is just near the pole. That's why the area remained frozen. Okay, so this is all about the oceans. In the next video, we will discuss about the seas.